Hello everyone, namaskar. So in this series of writing series, one more function is there in front of us. This is expand tan inverse x by Maclaurin's theorem. So again, we'll follow the standard algorithm or approach for this. First step, write whatever function is given as fx equals to that. Next, we need to find at least four derivatives. Okay, so you know derivative of tan inverse x is 1 upon 1 plus x square, but after that the finding derivative will become start becoming complex. But let's find at least one derivative and then we'll decide what to do further. So first derivative, you all know, 1 upon 1 plus x square. Now using quotient rule is something we try to avoid most of the time, but because it is a bit lengthier, instead we always prefer power rule. Okay, because that is simpler. So let's write it as 1 plus x square power minus 1. But this is something very interesting, because if you have some idea of binomial, then we know that 1 plus x power minus 1 is 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube plus x power 4 minus and so. This is a very important result. So if we were to use this, we can slightly modify our first derivative and write that as 1 minus of, in place of x we just have x square, so second term will be x square, then square that, so x power 4, further square that, so x power 6. Okay, x, then x square, x itself is x square, then x cube. Okay, and you can keep on writing, plus x power 8 minus. So this is your f dash x, fine. Now let's move forward, because now game is easy for us. Because even for x power n, you, someone asks you, find the derivative of x power 1000. You will happily say 1000 x power 999, fine. So f double dash x, if I calculate from here, so that will be derivative of 1 is 0, derivative of x square is 2x, derivative of x power 4 is 4x cube minus 6x power 5 plus 8x power 7. Now one thing more you have to keep in mind, that we are not concerned much about the derivative's actual value, but we are concerned more about the values of derivative at zero. So whenever x is there in any term, this is anyway going to give us zero, because you are further going to, in the next step, will put x as zero. So wherever you are seeing zero, x is there, so you can be sure that that term is going to become zero. Only the constant terms are important for us. So in f dash x, we got only one constant term. In f double dash x, no constant term is there. Okay, this term is going to vanish further. Let's find the triple derivative. So again, minus 2x, it will become minus 2. And plus 12x square minus 30x power 4 and plus 56x power 6 and so. Let's find the fourth and the final one. So fourth derivative is minus 2 derivative is again 0. 12x square will be 24x minus 120x cube. Fine. I'm not writing the next term because that is to contain x power 5. I'm not interested in those calculations. Because terms after this will, terms starting from here will start becoming 0 because they all will contain at least 1x. Fine, so we have calculated this. Now it's time to calculate their values at 0. So first of all, what was our function? Function is tan inverse x. So if I find tan inverse 0, that is 0. So f of 0 is tan inverse 0 and that is going to give us 0. Now next we are going to find the first derivative value at 0. So first derivative value at 0, wherever you have x that will become 0, only you will get 1. Next up we'll find the second derivative value at 0. And that, as you can see, it is going to come as 0. Third derivative value at 0, that will come out to be minus 2. And fourth derivative value at 0, that is going to come as 0. Looks like I am interested in some more terms because only two terms I have got, which is non-zero. Okay. Because fourth derivative at 0 is also 0. Can we find fifth derivative? At least one good term I want, so that's why I'm doing so. So let's find the fourth derivative, fifth derivative. So that will be 24. Okay, finally I got something better. Minus 360 x square and let it be plus dot dot. So fifth derivative, as you can see, at 0 will give us 24. So I am all set to write the Maclaurin's theorem result, which is fx equals to f of 0 plus x f dash 0 plus x square by 2 factorial. I hope you know how to remember this. Whatever is the power of x, same factorial and same order of derivative. So in first term, power of x is 0, so 0 factorial is divided by 0 factorial, which is 1, and 0 derivative is the function itself at 0. Okay. Then the first derivative divided by 1 factorial, and the first one is the order of derivative. Here again, f double dash 0 plus x cube by 3 factorial, f triple dash 0, and so on. Although I need more terms, I will go up to fifth derivative. Let's see. F x is nothing but tan inverse x. F of 0 I got, I think, 0 plus x times first derivative at 0 is 1, so that is 1 only. Second derivative is 0, so that term will vanish. Third derivative is minus 2. So third derivative is minus 2, so I will get minus of x cube by 3 factorial times 2. Then it what will come? X power 4 by 4 factorial, and I will get fourth derivative, but that is again 0. So coming to the fifth derivative, and that is positive, so x power 5 by 5 factorial, and that is multiplied by f fifth derivative at 0, which is 24, and this will go on and on. I am not concerned about the sign, that will be managed. Okay, now if I try to write it more cleanly, I would write this as x. 3 factorial is 6, so I will get 3 in denominator, so minus x cube by 3. एंड नेक्स्ट आई विल गेट एक्स पावर 5 बाय 5 फैक्टोरियल इज 120 व्हिच इज 24 इनटू 5 सो आई विल गेट 5 इन डिनोमिनेटर फाइन सो दिस इज व्हाट आई एम गेटिंग एज माय एक्सपेंशन यू आर गेटिंग सम पैटर्न आउट हियर व्हाटएवर इज द पावर ऑफ एक्स फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल पावर इज 1, 3, 5, 7 एंड सो ऑन ओके वी आर स्किपिंग द और इवन नंबर्स ओके एंड अल्टरनेट प्लस माइनस इज देयर सो कैन यू गेस द नेक्स्ट टर्म व्हिच इज गोइंग टू कम अप इट विल ऑब्वियसली हैव अ माइनस साइन इट विल हैव एक्स पावर एज 7 एंड डिनोमिनेटर द सेम थिंग विल बी देयर एंड यू कैन गेस द फर्दर टर्म्स ऑल्सो नेक्स्ट टर्म ऑब्वियसली विल गेट समथिंग पॉजिटिव एंड दैट इज फॉर यू टू फिल ओके इफ एट ऑल इट इज नीडेड इन अ प्रॉब्लम देन ओनली इफ यू आर जस्ट शोइंग द एक्सपेंशन 2 to 3 terms are sufficient. Sometimes 2 terms are also sufficient. If you are getting higher derivatives as 0 and calculation is a bit complex. Okay. So that's it for today. I think we have done it smartly enough. Otherwise, if you have gone like this 1 upon 1 plus x squared, then finding derivative, then finding it would have taken a bit more time. But then also, if you are patient enough, you would have done by that method also. You can watch out more such problem from Maclaurin's and Taylor's theorem in the playlist that I am having on that also. Thanks again.